This is Danica, and I design WordPress membership site. In this series, we are working on a LearnDash LMS website, and we're gonna learn how to set up the content of your courses with it. So in the past video, I have shown you how the course editor works, and in this video, we're gonna start adding the course itself. Now, before I do that, I'm just gonna change something in here. So first is in the settings sections, permalinks, I'm gonna change or make sure that it says post name. So make sure you do that and click save changes. Next is I'm gonna add a plugin, and it's instant image. So I'm gonna use that so that I could easily grab featured image for this demo courses that we are gonna be adding. Then activate. And then after that one, we will then proceed to adding the course content. So I'm gonna just turn the first to trash, and we're gonna create a new one. So here, we will be adding the title. So again, we will be borrowing content from this Udemy course that we found, and we're gonna try to mimic it, not in terms of layout, but in terms of content. So in here, we're gonna copy the course title, and then there's some descriptions. So I think I'm just gonna paste that here, and let's see how that works or how that looks. Not sure if I could copy the what you will learn. Okay, that's fine. And maybe I could also copy this. Okay, so it turned into bullet points, which is fine. So H2, so if I click this and whatever it says here, that is headline 2. Yep, that's fine. Okay, so let's just publish this, and let's quickly see how this looks. So I'm gonna view the course, and this is the default layout right now. So we have the title. This is from LearnDash. There's some progress indicator going on, and then we have the course included, what you learn, requirements, descriptions, and so on. So we're gonna edit it again, and this time we're gonna try to add the lessons. So there's some lessons and topics. We're gonna try to copy that one. So I'm gonna expand all of the sections here, and I'm gonna copy this. Now to add lessons and topics to this course, we're gonna use the LearnDash LMS Course Builder. So you can access that from this tab, Builder. And as you can see, there's some sections. There's like new lessons, section heading, and so on. So you could do that. So let's just say, example, this one. It's either you could use this as a heading, or maybe use that as a lessons, and these are like topics. But in my case, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this as a lesson, and then there's some topics. And then on the next example, we're gonna use this as a heading and then some lesson, something like that. So we're gonna play around in here. So I'm gonna copy this. So for copying, I'm just gonna inspect this element. I'm not sure if you could see my browser, but maybe what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna view page source, and I'm gonna look for getting started. Doesn't actually give me that one, so only the inspect element, but I can't show you from this recording, so I'm just gonna manually copy this and we're gonna do it that way. So getting started with, okay, so I'm gonna create a new lesson and it's gonna say getting started with practical mindfulness, and then I'm gonna click enter, or you could also click this add new button. After that, you could expand this more, and as you can see, you could add a topic underneath this lesson. So I'm gonna click new topic, and I'm gonna make this as topic. So it says welcome to. So welcome to practical mindfulness. Next is how to. So I'm gonna continue and copy all of this. Okay, so last but not the least is the exercise. So just added those as topics, and since that is an exercise, I'm gonna assume that needs to be a quiz. So I'm gonna add that as a quiz, and then I'm just gonna update this. So I'm gonna preview in a new tab, and if I scroll down, you can see that I now have my course content. If I expand this, it says I have this getting started, and I have the lesson content welcome, which is exactly the same here. So welcome, how mindfulness and meditation changed my life, and so on. And then we have the exercise. It also lists how many steps is in this lesson. So there's three topics, one quiz, and again it says that in here, and some percentage of how much has been completed for this section. Now I'm gonna add another one, and this time I'm gonna treat it as I'm gonna add some sections first. So example, I click that section, new section heading, and I'm gonna collapse this so that it doesn't confuse me. So new section heading, I'm gonna say start here. I'm gonna move that at the top. The next is continue. Depending on how your course works, this is just an example, but I'm gonna demonstrate to you how that's gonna look. So next is this one. So again, I'm gonna copy this, and I'm gonna create a new lesson, and I'm gonna continue and just add more so that we could like see this more in action. Again, I'm gonna click this so it expand, and I'm gonna do new topic, and as you can see, it's actually like a drop down thing. Next is on this mindfulness. I'm gonna add like two more. Okay, and then I'm gonna hit update. So now let's see how that looks. If I refresh here, so the headline that we did, it looks like sections that separates the two. So as you can see, we have the start here and we have the continue. And if we expand this, we could just expand this section. If we click expand all, it's gonna expand all of that section. Let me just try that again. Expand all. Okay, that works this time. So that's how it works. Now I'm gonna add a last a third lesson, just so you see how it looks if there's no like section dividing it. So I'm just gonna keep it simple, add one lesson, and I'm gonna add one topic. And then refresh. So as you can see, there is no section or headline dividing or separating these two, so they are very close. And if I click expand all, it's gonna look like this. Now let's just go back here and I'm gonna example this one, collapse all. So I'm gonna this close everything. So as you can see, the one that I have mentioned last time under settings, no, not in here, but it was under courses settings. So this steps, so steps displayed, it says 20, but I only have 11 steps right now, so it's not gonna limit that yet. But let's just say I'm gonna do 5 per page only, and if I refresh, well, so far that didn't work. I refresh here. Okay, well that did not do anything, but I was expecting it's that section because it says here 11 step in this course, and here it's course builder steps displayed. And so maybe that's not, that part is not working properly. Shared course steps and so on. Okay, but that's the section that I was referring to. So let's go back to this course builder before we proceed to the other sections. But in here, as you can see, we have a headline, a section heading, it's named section heading, and there is some lessons, and it says L, so it's lesson. If we expand this, it says T, so that's topic. And do note that you could actually rename this. It's not like forever topic or forever lesson. Even the course, you could rename that. But we're gonna keep it simple and use the default naming that LearnDash has. So lesson, topics, and we have the quiz. So that's how this works. So I'm gonna expand everything so that you could see. Now underneath the topic, you could actually drag a quiz inside, but you can't add another layer to it, only a quiz. So do note on that one. I'm gonna collapse this. And example, these are your lessons, right, and stuff. But you could also do a final quiz. So the way that's gonna look is, example, if I expand here, so you can see there the quizzes are inside the lesson. But example, let's just say they take all of this and you have some final examination for them. That is the usage of this final quiz. So I'm gonna create a new one. So final exam, and then maybe conclusion, depending on how this program or course works for your members, so you could add more. So that's how it's gonna look. It's gonna add it at the very bottom of the listing. So that's how you add a course using the page in the course builder. And in the next video, we're gonna check out the settings and the group tab.